ஹலோடா தங்கம், வெல்கம் டு கலி கிளாஸ் ரூம். திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபோர்த் லெக்சர் இன் விச் சாப்டர் சார்? இந்த சாப்டர் லைட் ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அண்ட் ரீஃப்ராக்ஷன். இன் சிபிஎஸ்இ 10th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஃபிசிக்ஸ் சயின்ஸ் புக்கு சாப்டர் 10 லைட் ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அண்ட் ரீஃப்ராக்ஷன். திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபோர்த் லெக்சர் தட் இஸ் டேக்கன் இன் இங்கிலீஷ். திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபோர்த் லெக்சர் தட் இஸ் டேக்கன் இன் இங்கிலீஷ். ஓகே சார், வாட் ஆர் வி கோயிங் டு ஸ்டடி இன் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் லெக்சர்? In this particular lecture, we are going to study about the sign conventions of spherical mirror. Also, we will study about mirror formula and we will do an in-depth analysis of what we can learn from the magnification value of a spherical mirror. So, this particular lecture, the contents of this particular lecture are very, very important to understand in order to do CBSE board problems, in order to work analytical problems based on spherical mirrors. Also, in order to better understand this particular lecture, you definitely need to study at least 25 minutes of the third lecture. In the third lecture, I have taught you what types of images are formed for different positions of objects in both concave mirror and convex mirror. In the third lecture, in the first 25 minutes, I have already taught you what type of images are being formed for the different positions of the objects for both concave mirror and convex mirror. You need to know that clearly in order to understand what is happening with respect to sign conventions. Yeah, can we start the lecture? Absolutely, sir. Absolutely, sir. So anyway, this is a converging mirror, concave mirror. This is a diverging mirror, convex mirror. In a concave mirror, the principal focus and the center of curvature are present in front of the mirror. In a convex diverging mirror, the principal focus and center of curvature are present behind the mirror. Okay, sir. All these things we have already studied in the previous lectures. What is new right now? Right now, the new thing we are going to learn is sign conventions for reflection by spherical mirror. Let us look at the first point. With respect to the first point, the object is always placed to the left of the spherical mirror. So this is the spherical mirror, the object right here. This is the spherical mirror, the object is placed always to the left of it. This is my left hand, this is my left hand. So the object is placed to the left of the spherical mirror. Light from the object falls on the mirror from the left hand side. Look here, this is my left hand side. Light is falling on the mirror from the left hand side. Light is coming from the left hand side. Light from some source, usually from the light source, a tube light right now. So the light from the tube light is coming and falling on the object and it is going towards the spherical mirror from the left hand side of the spherical mirror. From the left hand side of the spherical mirror. Yeah, are you comfortable with this? So the light must always come from this side to that side. The light must always come from this side to that side because you are placing the mirror in the right side, the object towards the left side, light comes from the left side to the right side. This will be done in each and every spherical mirror problem because this is the standard that we have accepted. Okay, sir, what next? All distances parallel to the principal axis are measured from the pole of the mirror. Sir, here this is the pole. So all distances horizontal to the principal axis will be measured from the pole. In order to better understand this particular second point, what are we going to do? We are going to complete this diagram. Here the object is placed beyond C in a concave mirror. The first light ray is passing parallel to the principal axis. Immediately it will pass through the principal focus. What next, sir? I am going to put a line that is going to be passing through center of curvature. I am going to put a line that is going to pass through center of curvature. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Let me redraw this diagram once more later, slightly below. I want a neat diagram over here. So this line is going like this. Let us extend the mirror. since the light ray is passing through the center of curvature, the light ray is going through the path of the normal. When the light ray is going through the path of the normal, what will happen? It will be reflected in such a way that it passes along the same path in the opposite direction. Both the light rays meet in between C and F, which will form a inverted diminished real image. So this is going to be the image right over here. Okay, sir. Now this, you have completed the diagram. Now, how are you going to relate this diagram with the second point? Look here, I want to measure the object distance from the pole. How am I supposed to measure the object distance from the pole? To measure the object distance from the pole, this is what I am going to do. So, I am putting a vertical line over the pole and I am measuring my distance from the pole. What is my object distance? My object distance is usually given as u. This is my object distance. So my object is placed beyond C. My object distance is given as u. So the object distance is measured from the pole. Are you able to understand it? From P, I am measuring till the object, and that is my object distance, which is indicated as u. Okay, sir, how is my image distance being measured? Here I have my image. Okay, so the image distance is given as V. The image distance is given as V. This is my image distance. V is my image distance. My image distance is given as V. Are you comfortable with how I am analyzing my second point? All distances parallel to the principal axis, which is taken as the x-axis. Let me repeat myself. All distances parallel to the principal axis, which is usually considered as x-axis, is measured from the pole, this particular point. So from the pole, where is my object present? That is going to be my u, object distance. From the pole, where is my image going to be present? It is present right over here in between center of curvature and principal focus. So from pole, I am going to measure this distance and note it as V, which is my image distance, which is my image distance. Okay, sir. Now let us try to understand the third point. Distances to the left of the pole are negative. Distances to the right of the pole are positive. How are you supposed to understand this particular point, sir? In order to understand this particular point, I need this diagram. I need the diagram of convex mirror. So let me redraw the diagram of the convex mirror slightly towards the bottom. Okay, this is going to be my principal axis. So here I am going to have my, okay, I am drawing a concave mirror. That is very bad of me. I want to draw a convex mirror. I am sorry about that. I apologize sincerely. Here I am going to draw a convex mirror. Okay, so for a convex mirror, I am going to draw the object right over here. I am going to draw an object right over here. What next? Here, the center of the spherical mirror is called as center of curvature. The middle point of the spherical mirror is called as pole. Between the center of curvature and pole, right in between the center of curvature and pole, I have my principal focus. Okay, sir, what is happening? Light is coming like this, hitting like this. Now let me continue with regard to the third point. Distances to the left of the pole are negative. What are they trying to tell here? If you are going to measure a distance towards the left of the pole, towards this side, this side is left, this side is right. If you are going to measure a distance towards the left of the pole, it is going to be negative. If you are going to measure a distance towards the right of the pole, it is going to be positive. This side, it is going to be negative. This side, it is going to be positive. Towards the left of the pole, it is going to be negative. Towards the right of the pole, it is going to be positive. Sir, help me understand this better. Okay, let us understand this particular idea better. Here, u is measured from this side. U is measured from this side. So, it has to be negative. V is also measured towards the left of the pole. So, it is negative. Sir, how am I supposed to better understand the third point? Help me in a better way. if you are going to study in higher secondary physics, they have given a very, very beautiful point. What, sir? This is the direction of the incident light. Let me repeat. This is the direction of the incident light. Okay. When you are going to measure something along the direction of the incident light, let us take it as positive. Okay. When you are going to measure something opposite to the direction of the incident light, automatically it is taken as negative. Look, this is the direction of the incident light. You are measuring u object distance opposite to the direction of the incident light. This is the direction of the incident light. You are measuring u from the pole, which is opposite to the direction of the incident light. Hence, u here is considered to be negative. Similarly, this is the direction of the incident light. You are going to measure v, which is the image distance opposite to the direction of the incident light from the pole to the image. So, v is also considered to be negative. Sir, give me another example in order to better understand what is happening. Let us consider this particular light ray. A parallel light ray to the principal axis and a convex mirror will be reflected in such a way that it is getting diverged from the focus. What next? If I am going to put a light ray towards C, what will happen? This particular light ray will be reflected along the same path, because a light ray towards the center of curvature is a light ray towards the normal, and a light ray towards the normal is reflected along the same path. So this is coming like this. Both these rays are diverging. Look here. Both these rays are diverging. So the diverging rays are meeting right over here, and I am getting a diminished virtual image. Beautiful. Here this is my image. Here this is my object. Now let us measure u, which is the object distance, and v, which is the image distance. Okay, sir. Let me use black in order to better understand what is happening. So here this is going to be u. I am going to measure u from the pole. When I am measuring u from the pole, I am measuring opposite to the direction of the incident light. So u is negative. When I am measuring v, which is along the direction of the incident light or towards the right of the pole. So this is going to be positive. V is going to be positive. Are you able to understand what is happening right over here? Here u is negative. Why, sir? U object distance is measured opposite to the direction of the incident light. Here v image distance is measured along the direction of the original incident light. So here v is considered to be positive. Okay sir. Now let us go for the next point. Distances measured perpendicularly above the principal axis is taken as positive. Absolutely. If you are going to measure the height of the object or image above the principal axis, it is usually positive. If you are going to measure the height of a image below the principal axis, automatically it is negative. How to understand this, sir? If I am going to measure the height of the object over here, it is positive. The height of the object is positive because above the principal axis. The height of the image is negative below the principal axis. Height of the image is given as HI. Height of the object is given as HO. What tells us? Similarly, here, height of the object, here it is positive because it is measured above the principal axis. What about here? I am getting a virtual diminished erect image means I will measure the height of the image above the principal axis. Automatically, the height of the image is positive. So, distances measured perpendicularly above the principal axis is positive, below the principal axis is negative. What next? Focal length of the concave mirror is taken as negative. How are you supposed to understand this particular point? Let us first try to analyze the focal length. What color can I use to measure the focal length? Let me use blue. From this point, I am measuring this as the focal length. From this point, I am measuring this shaded line as the focal length from the pole. I am measuring the focal length from the pole opposite to the direction of the incident light. Then automatically for a concave mirror, what is happening with respect to focal length? Focal length is negative because it is measured from the pole opposite to the direction of the incident light. Okay, sir. What about I have measured my focal length right over here. What about right over here? Focal length in a convex mirror is measured from the pole along the direction of the incident light. Look here, you are measuring the focal length along the direction of the incident light. If you are measuring along the direction of the incident light, then automatically the focal length is going to be positive. So the focal length of a concave mirror is negative. The focal length of a convex mirror is positive. So that has been written over here. Now, are you able to understand a complete analysis of what is happening? Horizontal distances, the simplest way to remember is in the direction of the incident light, automatically it is positive. Opposite to the direction of the incident light, automatically it is negative. Okay sir. What next, sir? Above the principal axis, all heights are positive. Below the principal axis, all heights are negative. Okay, sir. Now, how to understand the mirror formula? We will learn about the mirror formula in 10th standard itself. But this derivation will be learnt only when you are studying your higher secondary physics. In your physics second book of 12th standard, there is a particular unit called as ray optics. A very, very beautiful unit. In fact, a very, very important unit for NEET and IIT is called as ray optics, and it is present in physics second book, 12th standard. When going there, you will study in a better way on how to derive the mirror formula using simple geometry, and some similar triangles. So 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U is the mirror formula. Here V is nothing but image distance, U is nothing but object distance, F is nothing but the focal length of the mirror. Okay, sir, I am comfortable with the mirror formula. Kindly provide me a better understanding of magnification. Here, magnification for mirrors can be written as hee-ho. What is hee-ho? Hee-ho means height of the image divided by height of the object. Hee-ho means height of the image divided by height of the object. When you are measuring magnification, magnification is nothing but a comparison of the height of the image with respect to the height of the object. Magnification is nothing but a comparison of the height of the image with the height of the object. This can be derived as minus V by U. Okay. Sir, how am I supposed to remember this? Minus V by U? It is very, very easy. There are three lines over here. First line, second line, third line. So, minus V divided by U. Here also there are three lines. For 1, 2 and 3. So, what am I going to do? Minus V divided by U is my mirror formula. Is my magnification formula. Sir, give a better understanding of what is happening. Let us say magnification is equal to 1. What is happening? If magnification is equal to 1, M is equal to HI by HO. When both of them are of same value, you are simply cancelling them. Which means image height is equal to object height. Are you able to understand what is happening when magnification is equal to 1? When magnification is equal to 1, image height is equal to object height. What next, sir? What will happen when magnification is greater than 1? When magnification is greater than 1, automatically we are able to understand that the numerator is high and the denominator is low, which means image height is greater than object height. That is fine. What about the next idea? What if magnification is lesser than 1? If magnification is lesser than 1, automatically what is happening? M is equal to HI by HO. Here, the image is becoming smaller. The object is bigger. So the image is in fact diminished. If some value is lesser than 1, automatically we are able to understand that the denominator is going to be high. So here the denominator is HO object. So the height of the object is high. The image height is smaller. The image height, H-E-I-G-H-T, the image height, H-E-I-G-H-T, is smaller than that of the object height. Here the object height is larger. Here the object height is larger. Sir, why have you drawn two lines on two sides of the M? Here I have drawn two lines on the two sides of the M in an understanding that I am only considering the magnitude of the magnification. I am not bothered about plus and minus. Right now I am not bothered about whether magnification is positive or negative. I am simply bothered whether the value of magnification meets these conditions. If magnification is 1, image height is equal to object height. So let us say this is magnification 1. Before 1, if the magnification is less than 1, automatically you are getting a diminished image. If the magnification is less than 1, automatically you are getting a diminished image. If the magnification is greater than 1, automatically you are getting an enlarged image. If the magnification is equal to 1, the image size and the object size are one and the same. Are you able to understand this particular idea? Okay, sir. But kindly tell me, with respect to magnification, what will happen if magnification is a positive value or negative value? If magnification is a positive value, the understanding is that if the magnification is the positive value, the understanding is that I am getting a virtual and erect image. I am getting a virtual and a erect image. If magnification is negative, then sir, the understanding is that I will get a real and inverted image. I will get a real and inverted image. If here it is magnification. If magnification is positive, I will get a virtual and a erect image. If the magnification is negative, I will get a real and a inverted image. Are you able to understand all the important ideas with respect to magnification? How to analyze the actual magnitude of magnification, the actual value of magnification without considering the signs of positive and negative? How to in fact consider the signs of positive and negative with respect to magnification? Yeah, that's basically the end of sign conventions for spherical mirror. In the next lecture, we will look at a healthy number of problems that need to be worked out in order to better understand deeply this particular concept. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the lecture as much as I did, right? I enjoyed teaching you guys this lecture. I hope you guys enjoyed listening to me. Yeah, obviously, I enjoy reading your comments and I always reply to my comments. Subscribe to our channel, click the bell icon. Why, sir? Because we are going to have so much fun learning all the subjects, physics, chemistry, biology, economics, mathematics, everything here at Gully Classroom. Do promote our channel to your friends. We are going to have so much fun learning subjects to depth in our channel. Cheers and thank you.